हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम किंजल परमार। वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ डिजिटल फंडामेंटल्स। टुडे वी विल एक्सप्लोर व्हाई दिस डिजिटल फंडामेंटल सब्जेक्ट इज नेसेसरी टू लर्न। व्हाई डिजिटल फंडामेंटल? दिस डिजिटल फंडामेंटल सब्जेक्ट इज नेसेसरी फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स व्हिच यूज कंप्यूटर्स और व्हिच यूज दिस डिजिटल सिस्टम इन देयर study also. That's why this digital fundamental subject is necessary to learn. As a computer engineer, you have to work on this device, and this computer is basically worked on a digital system. Here in this computer, you gave the data in a normal form, and then this data is converted into digital form, or says more specifically in a binary form. So we have to understand the fundas of digital, or says we have to understand the fundas of this device. As in this computer is basically includes input output device, CPU, and or says in a CPU we have a memory. So this computer is basically assembled with input output devices, that is keyboard, mouse, and monitor, and this CPU which is used to process our data, which is used to analyze our data, and this data are analyzed in a binary form. So we have to learn about this fundas of digital. So for that we have to study this binary representation, how we represent our binary number. Then we have to study about this number system. As if we want to learn about binary, then we have to learn about this number system. Then we have to study about this binary operations, because our processor, or says our CPU, process our data in a binary form. So we have to learn about binary operations to understand the process of our central processing unit. Then we have this binary codes. As our binary information is represented in a different form, so we have to study about binary code in this fundamentals of digital. Then we have a combinational digital circuit. Why this combinational digital circuit? In a CPU, or says in a central processing unit, there are lots of operations like addition, subtraction, multiplexing, or says coding, decoding, and coding, comparison. All the operations are performed in a central processing unit. How the central processing units perform all the operations? So this CPU has a combinational digital circuit. So this CPU includes this combinational digital circuits. There are so many combinational digital circuit which used in a central processing unit to process our data in a various manner. So we have to study about this combinational digital circuit to understand how this CPU process our data. And we have another digital circuit, that is sequential digital circuit. Here this combinational digital circuit is basically simply process our data and give the output according to the inputs. But in a sequential logic circuit, there is a device, or says there is a circuit which stores the past data. So here this sequential digital circuit is basically for storing purpose and for analyzing purpose. So we have to again learn about the sequential digital circuit. That means how this processor can store our data and process our data. So we have to learn about this sequential digital circuit. Then we have this programmable logical device. In a computers or in some applications, the user can program a logic circuit according to the requirement. So how that user can do this, or says as a programmer how you can perform, or says how you can design a circuit according to the user requirement. So we have a programmable logic devices. So using this fundas of programmable logic devices, we can perform a varieties of operations according to the user's requirement. So we have to study about this programmable logic device. Then we have a semiconductor memories. In processor, our data is processed and our data is stored in the memories. So we have to study about various semiconductor memories, for example ROM, RAM and other kind of memories which is used to store the data. So how this memory is stored our data, and then how the data are retrieved to the computers for the process. So this all can be covered in this process. So we have to study about the semiconductor memories to understand the basic working of our CPU. Then we have a analog to digital converter. As a human, we work on an analog. Analog, that means continuous data. Here my audio is basically a analog signal, but it is processed into digital form and then it again delivered by analog form. So we have to study about this analog to digital and digital to analog conversion. So to understand the basic working of a computer, we have to study about this two types of data, that is analog data and digital data. As a human, we work, or says as a any of the devices, whenever we give the input to the our computer or says to the digital circuit, it is in the form of analog, that means it is in the form of continuous manner. But this digital circuit or our computer is basically work on a digital. So this analog data is converted into digital form and then it is processed. So we have to study about how this data is converted, and at the end we have a original data in our desired form. So there is a again another conversion, digital to analog. So we have to study about analog to digital conversion and digital to analog conversion to understand how the computer works. Then we have a logic families. In logic families, we basically study about different integrated circuit used for the basic operations. We have a basic logical operations are AND, OR, NAND, like this. So how this data is performed for this logical operations is basically by the integrated circuit in a real-time applications. So how this integrated circuit works is covered on this logical families topic. So in this session we discussed about why this digital fundamental subject is necessary to learn, and next session we start our video lecture series for the digital fundamentals. Thank you.